Hi guys, this is Lauren from Titer Robotics. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use a really cool feature that's present in our new flight stand software, and that's our simulated boards, our simulated test stands. So essentially, if you want to try out the software before buying a test stand, this feature lets you do that. So what you do is you go to the hardware tab, and normally this is where you would connect your flight stand via USB, but instead if you want to try the simulated board, you just click this button. And then you'll see on the left here, we have some baseline data coming in for powertrain 1, which is our simulated board. And then if we go to the manual control tab, we can activate the ESC for our simulated board and look at the data coming in. And it shows you all the parameters that you'll be able to measure with your flight stand: thrust, torque, voltage, current, RPM, power, and efficiency. But that's not all you can do. Let's say you wanted to simulate a coaxial or dual motor system. You just go back to the hardware tab and click Connect Simulated Board again, and that will add another simulated powertrain. So this is powertrain 2, and again we see the baseline data coming in. So we have the option to name and map these powertrains, which is what I've done here. So for powertrain 1, I've just called it motor 1, propeller 1, ESC 1. Same thing for powertrain 2, but with number 2. And what you can do is map the sources of data coming in. So in this case, we just want to make sure the data coming in for powertrain 1, which is simulated hardware DSA, is different from the ESC throttle for powertrain 2, which is simulated hardware VJE. So that's exactly what we want. So we'll go back to manual control, and now we can activate our second ESC, and we'll slide up the throttle controllers for each one. And then when we look at our real-time plots, we can again see data coming in for powertrain 1 and powertrain 2. And this feature doesn't just work for the manual control. You can also run automated tests with the simulated boards. Just go to the automated control tab. Your simulated boards will already be connected. Program a test, and then click run. And start, and it will take us through our test. So there you go. As you can see, again, the data for the simulated boards is coming in quite nicely. You can even save these tests. This one's just called Untitled. And then if we go to the test tab, you can see Untitled and look at our data plots from our simulated boards. If you'd like, you can review the powertrain mapping, the hardware, and export your data. So again, this is a great way to test out the software if you're thinking about buying a flight stand, and the simulated boards can be used with multiple powertrains to get the full software experience. So if you have any questions, feel free to leave us a comment below or send us an email, and we'll be sure to get back to you. Thanks for watching.